Papa Pet. That's fine, Peter. Now maybe the sleigh you bring around for Professor Moore.
Yeah, I do that now.
Oh, Clement, dear. You'll just have to have another bag.
Remember, I'm not staying. Just two lectures, that's all.
Can we help you, Pet? Do you have
age go fast?
Children, children, just a moment. Now, I'll be back in a few days. In plenty of time for Christmas. And I'll bring you each a present.
And Mama, too?
And Mama, too.
A doll. Can I have a doll? And some sugar plums? And a bow. A red one.
All right. But what do you want, Charity? Most of all?
Well, I'd like a book.
A book?
Uh-huh. About Santa Claus.
Well, I'll get you one.
Really? Promise?
I promise.
Oh, Clyde, what a funny dog you are.
Is the professor ready? Get out from here, you bad little dog.
I don't want you to catch cold.
I know. I'll be careful, dear.
Want me to get my book, Papa? You promised.
I'll not forget. You'll see.
Goodbye,
children.
Bye. Bye. Have a nice trip.
And meet me next Monday.
I will, Professor Moore.
Bye, Peter.
Goodbye.
Winter time, snowflake time, swirling all around. From the sky, bright diamonds fly and softly touch the ground. Winter time, big boot time. Crunching through the snow.
Frozen toes and cold nipped nose and cheeks of rosy glow.
Thank you.
year.
Get full.
That dog eats too much.
Oh, Clement, you have to have a nod at the end. You tie it for me, Carrie.
What's the matter, dear?
I don't feel good. I'm cold.
Oh, well, here, dear. It's time for bed, and Gretchen will fix a bed warmer for you. Come, Emily. Come, Clement. Bedtime.
Lullaby time. Sleepy lullaby time. Blossom not rosy hair. Each rose a daisy ever so late.
That answers your question.
Thank you, Professor Moore. I'd like to keep you longer, but we know you have things to do before you meet the stage. Thank you again.
This is exactly the right boat, exactly. Even the color. And the big doll, perfect. The storybook about St. Nicholas.
But I've never heard of a book about the good saint. Maybe...
I know. I've tried everywhere.
Maybe your little girl would like this music box. It's hand-carved and the melody
is... Oh, I'm sure she would, but still, I promised the book and I...
But there is no book printed, sir.
Well, Charity will understand that, I'm sure. All right, the music box it is.
A very sick little girl, Mrs. Moore. Very sick.
Oh, if only her father were here.
When will he be back?
Not until tomorrow.
Then I'd better stay. We must keep her warm and wait. There's not much else we can do.
Bye, Mr. Mabel. I'll see you after Christmas.
Professor Moore! Professor Moore! We must hurry.
What is the matter, Peter? I've never known you to be so...
Charity, she is so sick.
Charity? Sick? What's wrong with her?
Oh, she is just terrible, Professor Moore. We must hurry. The doctor says we must hurry.
How is she, Catherine?
Oh, Clement, thank God you're home. Charity has pneumonia.
I can't find my home, my books, and
my... That's all she says. She's delirious. A very sick little girl.
Can't you help her, Doctor? Isn't there anything we can do?
We've done everything we know. We must wait now. Wait for even a small miracle.
Papa, where's Papa?
I'm here, dear. I'm here.
Where's Papa? Can't find my sample.
Oh, that's mostly what she says. Did you get the book, dear?
No book in print. Not a one. Oh, I tried everywhere.
The crisis is some hours away. You've had a long journey. Perhaps you should rest.
No, I'm all right. I must stay with her. Charity, listen. It's your present. Hear the music? Listen.
My story. Santa, where's Popeye?
It's no use. No use.
Maybe if you could just tell her a story. Could you?
Oh, even if St. Nicholas himself were here. Wait. St. Nicholas comes to see, visits. A visit from St. Nicholas.
Where's Papa?
Shh, Charity. I'll read you your story in a little while. Just sleep now. That's it. Rest. Then I'll have your story. Charity, can you hear me? Charity?
She's quieter now. Perhaps we shouldn't...
But it's what she's been begging for.
Charity, dear. Charity. Listen. Listen to your Santa Claus story. This is the present. Do you hear, sweetheart? Your story.
My story.
Your story. It's called A Visit from St. Nicholas.
See?
Santa Claus. And this is the way the story goes. Listen. Twas the night before Christmas. Twas the night before Christmas. And all through the house, not a creature was stirring. Not even a mouse.
Thank you. what was the matter? Away through the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, threw open the sash.
Chuckle and a smile I knew all. hard, but went straight to his heart. He filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk. Laying a finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle.
Christmas after all.
Tis the morning of Christmas and all through the house. Not a creature is sleeping, not even a mouse. The presents are there by the fireplace, I know. Where St. Nicholas left them a short time ago. Things are filled up with candy and nutmegs and toys, just waiting for dear little girls and for good little boys. All through with his work Santa puts on his head, he's ready at last for a long winter's night. He whispers